Yes. Hello students, welcome to GradeUp, India's largest online platform for GATE, ESC and PSUs for other competitive exams. Students, all of you, very good morning. Welcome to the session. Yes, students, all of you, good morning. Yes. Arjun, good morning. Welcome to the session. Yes. A very good morning, all of you. Arun, good morning. Welcome to the session. Today, I'm going to discussing a very important and most expected models of questions in electrical measurements. Yes, students who are preparing for all HPCL, this is most important models of questions that I am going to discuss. Mainly, I am concentrating on the electrical measurements. I already done one series on the electronic measurements, CRO and transducers. You please go through that series, students. Mainly, in this series, I am going to discussing important models of questions in electrical measurements. Yes. Sirisha, good morning. Yes. Hari, good morning. Yes. All of you, very good morning, students. I think antenna topic is not there for Tribuli. Hari. Yes, it is not there for Tribuli. Yes. All of you, very good morning, students. Yes, students, before starting the today questions, topic questions, first let me introduce myself. Yeah, no antenna questions for Tribuli. Yes. Yes, friends. First, let me introduce myself, students. My name is Surendra Babu. For 10 years, I am educating the students for GATE, ESC and PSUs in Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Friends, these are the subjects I am teaching for various competitive point of view: network theory, power electronics, electrical machines, power systems, measurements, transducers and mechanical instrumentation. Yes, students, this is our GradeUp Super. Who are the aspirants for GATE, ESC and PSUs for structured course, subscribe for GradeUp Super, students. For more information, contact this number. Yes, students, these are our star faculty in GradeUp Electrical. Please go through the lectures of all our star faculty in app classes and YouTube classes. Friends, this is one announcement. There is a medal of success. Flat 50% off on GradeUp Super for GATE, ESC and PSUs. Use the code of medal 50, get the 50% off on GradeUp Super, students. You please utilize this opportunity. Yes, students, this is my Telegram channel. Who are the aspirants for GATE, ESC and PSUs? For more updates about my lectures and you have any doubts, clarification, you please join this channel. Yes. Yes, all of you, very good morning, students. Welcome to the session. Yeah, Arjun, we will plan. Actually, already other our faculty or star faculty is also taking the classes in other subjects also. You please follow that subjects also. Yes. Yes, friends. Naveen Kotra, good morning. Yes. Sudhakar, good morning. Abhishek, good morning. Pramod Kumar, good morning. Yeah. Arjun, good morning. Yes, friends. The first question is displaying on the screen. Can anybody answer this question, friends? Quick. A spring control moving iron voltmeter draws a current of 1 milliampere. Yes. Yes, friends. For full scale value of 100 volts, if it draws a current of 0.5 milliampere, the meter reading is. What is the answer, students? A spring control moving iron voltmeter. This is the question based on the MI instrument. This is the question based on the MI instrument, friends. Can anybody answer this one? Then how to answer this question? Yes, students, please concentrate, all of you. How to answer this question? Yes, friends. Yeah, this is the question based on the moving iron instrument. Yeah. We know that in spring control, theta is proportional to I square. Theta is proportional to I square, friends. Then how to write theta 2 by theta 1 equal to I 2 square by I 1 square. I 2 square by I 1 square. then you want reading theta 2. Then what is the theta 2, students? What is I2? It is given 0.5 milliampere. This I1 is given is how much? 1 milliampere. That is 0.5 by 1 whole square into theta 2. Theta 2 how much, students? It is 100 volts. Then what is the reading of theta 2? Can anybody answer this one? Yes, very good. 25 volts. Very good, friends. Theta 2 equal to 25 volts. After completing the class, I will share in my Telegram channel. Mohammed, you please take that one. Yes, Mohammed. Yes, friends, all of you, very good morning. Welcome to the session. Yeah, this is the question based on the spring control, friends. We know that in a moving iron instrument, theta is proportional to I square. This formula also you remember, friends. In moving iron instrument, please concentrate, friends. Along with some important points also I am giving, please concentrate. In moving iron instrument, theta equal to 1 by 2k I square into dl by d theta. Very important. 1 by 2k I square into dl by d theta. This formula also you remember. What is the expression for deflection of an angle? The deflection of the pointer equal to 1 by 2k into I square into dl by d theta. If dl by d theta is constant, theta is proportional to I square. That's why this is the moving iron instrument. This is the, what is the deflecting torque? What is the deflecting torque, student? Of I square into dl by d theta. This formula is also very important. Direct deflecting torque equation also we can expect. Direct deflecting torque equation also we can expect, students. This is the deflecting torque equation of which instrument? All this is for moving iron instruments. Please concentrate. All this is for which instruments, friends? Moving iron instruments. Please concentrate. Very important formulas. Moving iron instruments. Yes, friends. Theta 1 by 2k I square into dl by d theta. Where theta is the deflection of the pointer. How much angle it can deflect? Oh, sir, what is this? This is mainly for measurements who are preparing for all HPCL. This is most important models of questions. Yes, Amit, good morning. Yes, friends. Come on, friends. One more question. An ammeter has a current of range 0 to 5 amperes and its internal resistance of 0.2 ohms. In order to change the range to 0 to 25 amperes, we need a resistance of. Yes, friends. This is the question based on PMMC as an ammeter. This is the question based on the PMMC as a ammeter, friends. PMMC as a ammeter. This is the question based on the PMMC as a ammeter. I think all of you know this one. To convert PMMC as a ammeter, what you can do, friends? A low value of shunt resistance is connected. A low value of shunt resistance is connected. At this point, you remember, friends, to convert PMMC as a ammeter. Then, what is that value of shunt resistance, friends? That value of shunt resistance RSH equal to RM by M minus 1. That formula, very important. Then, what is M, friends? M equal to I by IM. What is I? M here, I by IM. It is called multiplying power or multiplying factor. It is called multiplying power or it is also called multiplying factor. It is also called multiplying factor. Yes, friends. All of you, very good morning, friends. Yeah. Pramod Kumar, your given answer is 0.05. Yeah. You check this one. Yes, friends. Then always M is high value by low value. Point to remember, friends. Always high value by low value. Then what is M you can get, friends? This M equal to then 25 by 5. 25 by 5. This is equal to 5. Then what is RM? It is given. RM is 0.2, friends. 0.2 is, this is 5 minus 1. Then 0.2 by 4. That 0.2 by 4 is how much, friends? This is nearly equal to 0.05 ohms. This 0.05 ohms, you connect in series or parallel, friends. This 0.05 ohms is in parallel with the meter. Because we are converting as a meter. Very good, Amit. Option D is correct. Very good, very good. Yes. Shirisha, very good. Option D is correct. Yeah, Pramod Kumar, you given. Yes, very good. Yes, friends, you please concentrate. This is 0.05 ohms in parallel with meter. Okay, this is very important formula, students. Please concentrate. Okay, to convert PMMC as a ammeter, what the value of shunt resistance? What is M here? M is the multiplying power or multiplying factor. Yes. One more question, students. Come on. Yeah, this is the 4 root 2. 4 root 2. Yes. The current I equal to 3 plus 4 root 2 sine 314 t is passing through PMMC, MI and hot wire meter. The readings of each meter is. What the PMMC measures, friends? PMMC measures the average value. What the MI measures, friends? RMS value. RMS value. What the hot wire meter measures, friends? RMS value. Yes. PMMC measures average, MI measures RMS, hot wire meter is also measure the RMS value. Given is what the current, students? The current I equal to 3 plus 4 root 2 sine 314 t. 4 root 2 sine 314 t. Yes, come on, students. What is the reading of the PMMC meter? The reading of the PMMC meter is the PMMC measure the average value. For this type of expressions, what is I average? I have a constant, this constant indicates the average value. Constant indicate the average value. What are the MI measures, friends? MI measure the RMS value. Whatever the input we can give, what are the MI measures? RMS value. For this type of expression, how to find the RMS value? Yes, all of you know this one. 3 square plus 4 root 2 by root 2 whole square, students. This is how much we can get? 5 amperes. Then what the hot wire meter? Hot wire meter also measures which? Hot wire meter is also measures which current, students? RMS currents. This is also 5 amperes. 3 amperes, 5 amperes, 5 amperes. Which option is correct? Very good, Pramod. Very good, Amit. Yeah. Yes, very good, Anupam Kumar. Very good. Yeah, option A is correct. 3 amperes, 5 amperes, 5 amperes. Yes, friends, please concentrate. This model is also important for computer exams. Yes. One more question, students. Point to remember here, I am giving the note. I think all of you well known about this one. Who are not known about this formula, you please concentrate. If I equal to A naught plus either voltage or current, students, A1 sin omega t, it may be sine or cos function, whatever may be, no problem. This are A2 sin 2 omega t plus and so on. For this type of expressions, what are the average, students? Average equal to A naught. What are the RMS, students? How to find the RMS? You please remember this expression to solve these models of questions. A naught square plus A1 by root 2 whole square plus A2 by root 2 whole square plus and so on. This formula I applied for previous problems. At this point you remember. It may be sine function or cosine function, this is applicable. It may be current or voltage, this formula is applicable. Yes, friends. All of you, very good morning. Welcome to the session. Yes. Come on, friends, one more question. A galvanometer with a full scale current of 10 milliampere has a resistance of 1000 ohms. The multiplying power of a 100 ohm shunt with this galvanometer is, you want to find the multiplying factor, friends. Come on, friends, how to find the multiplying factor for this problem? Okay, what is the multiplying factor? Yes, friends, we know that RSH equal to RM by M minus 1. RSH equal to RM by M minus 1. Then from this one, what is M minus 1 equal to, friends? M minus 1 equal to RM by RSH. RM by RSH. Then what is M equal to? Yes, friends. RM by RSH plus 1. How much meter resistance is given? Meter resistance is 1000 ohms. What is the shunt resistance, students? 100 ohms plus 1. How much multiplying factor we can get? 11. The multiplying factor equal to 11. Come on, friends. Come on. Yeah. Abhishek, we will plan. I am taking the power electronics also. Power electronics. The another subject I am taking, power electronics for Hall HPCL. Yes, friends. Very good. Option C is correct, friends. You please concentrate. Very important models of questions. Very simple questions we can expect for Hall and HPCL point of view. You please concentrate, students. You please concentrate. Today, all the electrical measurements I am giving. All the electrical measurements I am going to giving the questions. All the electrical measurements. Already I done the electronic measurement series. You please go through that question. That questions are enough for the Hall and HPCL also. But if there is any lengthy questions are there, what I covered in the previous series, I will share that link also, students. You please go through that one. For electronic measurements, I done the questions on transducers, CRO, rectifier typing. rectify type instrument, amplify type instrument, all these I already done on electronic measurements. Please go through that series. But here I am covering the electrical measurement series. Yes, students. Yes. Come on, students. One more question. The coil of a PMMC ammeter of 100 tons, 40 mm long and 30 mm wide. The control torque is 240 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Newton meter on full scale. If the magnetic flux density in the air gap is 1 Weber per meter square, what will be the range of the ammeter? What will be the range of the, that means by using this what current we can measure? By using this what current we can measure? Yes, friends, this is the question based on the deflecting torque equation of PMMC instrument. This is the question based on the deflecting torque. What is TD equal, friends? In PMMC instrument, TD equal to NBIA. Come on, students. This is for PMMC instrument. For PMMC instrument, what the TD equal? TD equal to NBIA. Then you want I, students. What is I? TD by NBA. TD by NBA. Then how much deflecting torque is given? 240 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Come on, students. 240 into 10 to the power of minus 6. How many number of tons it is given? 100 tons. What the flux density it is given, friends? 1 Weber per meter square. What the area of the coil? Area of the coil, 40 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Yes, friends. This is 30 into 10 to the power of minus 3. How much we can get? Come on, friends. How much current we can get? Yes, Hari. It is the most expected models of questions. Most expected models of questions. Yes, all of you. Very good morning. Welcome to the session, friends. Which option is correct, sir? Which option is correct? Very good, very good. How much we can get, friends? 2 milliampere. Very good. But in this case, you also remember one formula, students. Very important. This is the question based on the deflecting torque equation of PMMC instrument. We know that in PMMC instrument, friends, at steady state, yes, friends, if the pointer is at steady state condition, TD equal to TC. What is TD, students? NBIA. What is TC, students? K theta. Then what is theta equal to? NBIA by K. Very important. This formula also you concentrate. Very important formula. Yes, sir. This you remember. If the pointer is at steady state condition, the deflecting torque equal to controlling torque. Let assume that here the spring control. We are assuming that spring control. Unless otherwise specified, you take the spring control. TC equal to K theta. Theta equal to NBIA by K. This formula is also important, friends. Because covering all the problems by using all the formulas in the less duration of time, it is very difficult. That's why I am giving some important formulas also. Yes, student, theta is proportional to I. That means in PMMC instrument, scale is the linear or uniform scale. In PMMC instrument, scale is linear or uniform scale. In MI instrument, scale is non-linear or non-uniform scale, students. Yes, friends. You please concentrate. This formula also you concentrate. Next. Come on, friends. One more question. A moving coil meter has a resistance of 3 ohms and gives full scale deflection with 30 milliamperes. What external resistance should be added in series so that it can measure voltage up to 300 volts? Yes, friends. This is the question based on the PMMC as a voltmeter. This is the question. Very important model, sir. 5-star model. PMMC as a ammeter, PMMC as a voltmeter. 5-star model of question. This is the question based on the PMMC as a voltmeter. To convert PMMC as a voltmeter, a high value of series resistance is connected. Students, a high value of series resistance is connected. Yes, friends. What is that value of series resistance? RSC equal to RM into M minus 1. RSC equal to RM into M minus 1, friends. What is M here, friends? M is the multiplying power or multiplying factor. V by Vm. How much voltage we are extending? 300 volts. High voltage by low voltage. Simply you remember high value by low value. What is Vm, friends? Vm equal to Im into Rm. Vm equal to Im into Rm. This is a Vm directly not given. You take Im into Rm, friends. Then what is M you can get? 300 by, yes friends, how much IM it is given? 30 milliampere. 30 into 10 power minus 3. This is 3. Then you substitute here. Then how much we can get, friends? This you can substitute here. 300 by 30 milliampere it is given. The 30 into, that is how much we can get this, you can substitute here, friends. RM is meter resistance is 3. M is 300 by, yeah, this you simplify. 90 into 10 to the power of minus 3 minus 1. Now this we can get 3997 ohms. 3997 ohms. Yes, do that calculation, friends. 3997 ohms. Yes, it is the EC students also. Measurement is there for EC students also. Yes, it is useful for EC students and electrical students. Common subject. Yes, students, please concentrate. You please concentrate. This subject is there for EC students also. Yes, friends, please concentrate. How much we are getting? This formula you want to remember. This formula you want to remember. You please concentrate. Yeah, this is the PMMC as a voltmeter. Yes. Come on, friends. One more question is displaying. Very good. Very good. All are giving correct answers. Very good, sir. Very good. You are very good in electrical and electronic measurements. Yes. Yes, friends. If one of the control spring of a permanent magnet coil ammeter is broken, then on being connected, it will read. Yes, friends. This statement is important. Then on being connected means already the meter is under operation. Already the meter is under operation, students. If suddenly, if one of the spring is damaged, then what is the reading of the meter? Yes, what is the reading of the meter? Come on, friends. Come on. Yes, friends. Conditions are important. Conditions are important here. Then on being connected, let us assume that already the pointer is at X reading. Already the pointer is at X reading. Already the pointer is at X reading, students. Then if suddenly one spring is damaged, we know that TC equal to K theta. See, friends, if one of the control spring of permanent magnet coil ammeter is broken, then on being connected, it will read. Then, friends, TC equal to K theta. Then what is the K equal to? This theta equal to TC by K. If one of the spring is damaged, theta dash equal to TC by, if one of the spring is damaged, you know that in PMMC instrument, there is a two springs. One is upper spring, another one is bottom spring. We are allowing the current through springs, friends. If what is the K equivalent? K equivalent equal to K by 2. If one of the spring is not working, then what? Sorry, K equivalent equal to K. If one of the spring is not working, if both the springs are working, K equivalent equal to K. If one of the spring is not working, K equivalent equal to K by 2. Then it becomes K by 2. Then what you can get, student? 2 into TC by K. 2 into TC by K means theta dash equal to 2 theta. That means instantaneously it shows the double the reading. But finally it comes to the zero position. If one of the control spring of permanent coil ammeter is broken, then on being connected, it will read twice the corrected values. But finally it is not asked. Finally it comes to the zero. But instantaneously how much it reads? It reads the twice the value, sir. Yes, friends, please concentrate. Instantaneously it reads the twice the value. Finally it comes to the zero. No doubt at all. Finally it comes to the zero. But here the question is being connected. Instantaneously it takes the twice the reading if one of the spring is damaged. But finally it comes to the zero position. Please concentrate. Statement you concentrate, friends. Yes. For example, when I am asking the question like this, during switch on the supply, if one spring is damaged, here I am giving one statement. Please concentrate. Yeah, this is the, yes, friends, two springs in PMMC meter. We are allowing the current through springs. That means in PMMC instrument, springs carrying the current. In PMMC instrument, springs carry the current. That point important.
during switch on the supply. Suddenly I close the switch, but if one of the spring is broken, if one of the spring is broken, then what the current becomes? What the current becomes, students? Current becomes zero. There is no current through the meter. Then what the reading of the meter? The meter shows the zero reading. The meter shows the zero reading. One more question, students. One more question. For example, already the pointer is X reading. Already the pointer is X reading. Here the case is during switch on the supply. During switch on the supply. During switch on the supply. If one of the spring is damaged. If one of the spring is damaged. If one of the spring is damaged. What the reading of the meter? If one of the spring is damaged. What the reading of the meter, friends? Damage, then theta equal to 0. The meter reading equal to 0. Now, already the pointer is at X reading. This is the case. This is the second case. This is the third case. Already first case I given. Okay. Already the pointer is X reading. If both the springs are damaged. If both the springs are damaged. Now, can anybody answer, students? Both the springs are damaged. Then what the reading of the meter? Can anybody answer this one? If both the springs are damaged, what the reading of the meter? If both the springs are damaged, what the reading of the meter? Then the pointer shows the full scale deflection. The pointer shows the full scale deflection. Very important. The pointer shows the full scale deflection. Full scale deflection. The pointer shows the full scale deflection. Yes. In this case, during switch on the supply, if one of the spring is damaged, the meter reading equal to 0. Already the pointer is at X reading. Already the pointer is at X reading. If both the springs are damaged, if both the springs are damaged, the pointer shows the full scale deflection. This concept you remember with respect to PMMC instrument. But students, if the same question is asked for MI instrument, if the same question is asked for MI instrument, during switch on the supply, if one spring is damaged, both the springs are damaged. Already the pointer is at X reading. If one spring is damaged or both the springs are damaged, always the pointer goes to the full scale deflection. The pointer goes to the full scale deflection. In the case of MI type instrument, only one answer. If any spring is damaged, if any spring is damaged in MI type instrument, always the pointer goes to the full scale deflection. That point you remember, students. Yeah, very important. Yes, very good, friends. Next. Come on, friends. Can anybody answer this one? A swamping resistance is connected. Come on, friends. Can anybody answer this question? A swamping resistance is connected. Yes. A swamping resistance is connected. Yes, friends. Swamping resistance is connected. Can anybody answer this one? Yes, friend. In series with the shunt to reduce the temperature errors in shunted meter. In series with the ammeters to reduce the errors on account of friction. In series with meter and have a high resistance temperature coefficient. In series with meter. Yes. Option D is correct, friends. Where we can connect the swamping resistance. Very important. In series with the meter and having negligible resistance of coefficient in order to reduce the temperature errors in shunt ammeters. The option is, yes, whatever the material we are using, that material, the swamping resistance material must be negligible temperature coefficient. That material made, that swamping resistance is made with negligible temperature coefficient, friends. Always swamping resistance is connected in series with meter. Very important points. It is connected in series with meter. What the purpose of using the swamping resistance? To reduce the temperature errors. To reduce the temperature errors, friends. Always point to remember. Here I am giving note point. Yes, friends. I am giving the note point. You please concentrate. Swamping resistance is made with magnet material. Please concentrate, sir. Swamping resistance is made with swamping resistance is made with which material, friends? Resistance is made with which material? Come on. Made with manganon resistance. Made with manganon. It is made with manganon material. Manganon. This is the negligible temperature coefficient. having a negligible temperature coefficient. Temperature coefficient. Negligible temperature coefficient. Manganese is constant. Manganese plus constant. Manganese is constant. Is the negligible temperature coefficient. Which of the following materials are having nearly zero temperature coefficient or negligible temperature coefficient? Friends, manganese is constant. Always swamping resistance is connected in series with meter. Always you can select the swamping resistance equal to 20 to 30 times of meter resistance. 20 to 30 times of meter resistance, friends. Always you can select the swamping resistance is 20 to 30 times of meter resistance. This is used to reduce the temperature errors. To reduce temperature errors in. To reduce temperature errors in. Shunt meters or shunt meters. Temperature errors in shunt connected meters. Shunt connected meters. But point to remember, friends. Shunt connected meters. No need of any swamping resistance in the case of voltmeters. No need of any swamping resistance in the case of voltmeters. Mainly for ammeters only we are using the swamping resistance. For ammeters. For ammeters only we can use the swamping resistance. For ammeters only we can use. No need of any swamping resistance for voltmeters. Yes, friends. Okay, this point also you remember. Yes, very important point, friends. It is used only for ammeters. No need of any swamping resistance for voltmeters. Yes. These are made with manganese material. This is swamping resistance is made with 20:1 ratio or 30:1 ratio. Manganese plus copper. It consists of manganese plus copper. Generally, this consists of manganese plus copper 20:1 ratio or 30:1 ratio. Yeah, this is called swamping resistance. Come on, friends. Always it is connected in series with meter. It is connected in series with meter. Come on, friends. One more point. One more question. The frequency range of moving iron instrument is. Can anybody answer, sir? What is the frequency range of moving iron instruments? What is the frequency range of moving iron instruments, friends? Can anybody answer this one? What is the frequency range of moving iron instruments? Yes, friends. What is the frequency range of moving iron instruments? Come on, friends. Which option is correct? The frequency range of moving iron instruments is very important question. We can expect. The frequency range of moving iron instrument is 0 to 125 Hz. These are used for a frequency range of 0 to 125 Hz. These are used for a frequency range of. For power frequencies, moving iron instruments are more preferable. For power frequency, these are more preferable. These are more preferable. That point to remember. These are more preferable, friends. Among all the instruments, these are the less cost. Among all the instruments. Come on, friends. Among all the instruments, these are the less cost. Instruments, these are less cost. These are less cost. And these are more preferable as a panel mounted instruments. These are very important points. These are more preferable as a panel mounted instruments. Preferable as panel mounted instruments. Panel mounted instruments. Yes, friends. These as a voltmeters or ammeter, more preferable practically to measure AC. More preferable practically to measure AC voltage and current. AC voltage and current, friends. Why these are, even though these are less accurate instruments, why these are more preferable? Because of less cost. Among all the instruments, which is the cheapest instrument? Moving iron instruments are the very cheap. Yeah, these are more preferable practically, friends. These are used for a frequency range of 0 to 125 Hz. Yes, Agarwal, we may expect that is optical instrumentation. We may expect optical and mechanical instrumentation. All this we can expect 10 to 12 questions. But for measurements, we can expect 6 to 8. A total, we can expect nearly up to 20 questions. 18 to 20 questions we may expect. That is the weightage we can expect. Yes. Yes, friends. One more point to remember, friends. One more point to remember. I'm asking one question. I'm not framed that question. Then EDM instruments, electrodynamometer type instrument. EDM instruments means electrodynamometer type instruments are also called EMMC instruments. Electrodynamometer type instruments are EMMC instruments, friends. These are used for a frequency range of 40 Hz to 500 Hz. 40 Hz to 500 Hz, friends. More accurately, we can use 40 Hz to 500 Hz. 40 Hz to 500 Hz. We can use 40 Hz to 500 Hz. But these are used 40 Hz to 500 Hz more accurately. If you use below 40 Hz or below 15 Hz, mainly below 15 Hz, the point will oscillate. It cannot show the exact reading. That's why these are used for a frequency range of 40 Hz to 500 Hz more accurately. And with reduced accuracy, yes friends, these are used 15 Hz to 1000 Hz. More accurately, we can use 40 Hz to 500 Hz, students. But with reduced accuracy, 15 Hz to 1000 Hz you can use. And one more point you remember, using astatic movement, very important. Using astatic movement, these are used up to 10 kHz. These are used up to 10 kHz also. But using astatic movement. Yes, astatic movements means additional moving coil. It consists of additional moving coil. The astatic movement is used to reduce the stray magnetic field effect. To eliminate the stray magnetic field effect, we are using astatic movement. Astatic movement means additional moving coil it consists of. Additional moving coil it consists. Using astatic movement, we can use up to 10 kHz also. But this frequency range we can remember. EDM instruments are used 40 Hz to 500 Hz more accurately. Yes, friends. It is for electronics also. Yes. Soumya, it is also for electronics. Electronics also it is useful. Yes, friends, come on. One more question, friends. Come on, friends. The sensitivity of a PMMC instrument is 10 kilo ohm per volt. This is the question based on the sensitivity. If this instrument is used in rectifier type voltmeter with half wave rectification, what would be the sensitivity? Yes, friends. Yeah, it is the question based on the rectifier type voltmeter. We know this one in half wave rectifier type voltmeter, friends. Please concentrate. In half wave rectifier type voltmeter, given is in half wave rectifier type voltmeter. In half wave rectifier type voltmeter. Come on, friends. In half wave rectifier type voltmeter, SAC of half wave rectifier equal to half wave rectifier type. AC sensitivity of half wave rectifier voltmeter equal to how much, friends? 0.45 times of SDC. 0.45 times of SDC. Then what the SAC of half wave rectifier, friends? SAC of half wave rectifier 0.45 times of what is SDC? SDC equal to 1 by full scale deflection current. What is the SDC? This is the DC sensitivity of PMMC meters, friends. 1 by full scale deflection current. 1 by full scale deflection current. DC sensitivity is defined for which meter? Come on, friends. DC sensitivity is defined for which one? PMMC meter. This is defined for PMMC meter. What the full scale deflection current is given? Yes, friends. But here it is not given. Directly sensitivity is given. Here directly sensitivity is given. 0.45 into sensitivity is how much, friends? 10 kilo ohm per volt. Then what you can get? 4.5 kilo ohm per volt. 4.5 kilo ohm per volt. Very good. Option B is correct. Very good, friends. Very good. Option B is correct. Yes. Can you get PDF this PDF? Yes, Mukesh Kumar, you can get the PDF and you join my Telegram channel. In that Telegram channel, I will share. Okay, friends. Yeah, it is for electronics also. You can get the PDF soon, Mukesh. You can get the PDF. Hari, I am not taking electrical circuits. I am going to taking the most expected models of questions based on the power electronics in the next coming sessions. Yes, friends. Very good. Abhishek, very good. Anupam Kumar, very good. Amit, very good. Option B is correct. Yes, students, one more point you remember, note point. This problem I framed for half wave rectifier. If the same question is asked for full wave rectifier, SACR full wave rectifier equal to, what the formula, students? SACR full wave rectifier equal to 0.9 times of SDC. 0.9 times of SDC. This point also you remember. SACR full wave rectifier equal to 0.9 times of SDC. Come on, students. One more question. The pointer of a moving coil ammeter deflects from 0 and comes to rest at 2 ampere in the steady state deflection position. Yeah. Which option is correct, students? The pointer of a moving coil ammeter deflects from 0 and comes to the rest at 2 amperes marking. That means the pointer of the PMMC instrument is showing at 2 amperes. It's showing at 2 amperes. Then it is at steady state condition. At steady state condition, if the pointer is at steady state, if the pointer is at steady state, students, if the pointer is at steady state, deflecting torque equal to controlling torque. Then which torque equal to 0? At steady state condition, which torque is 0, students? Come on. At steady state, which torque is 0? Damping torque equal to 0. Damping torque equal to 0. Very important. Then which torque is 0, students? Damping torque is 0. I am asking one more question here. If the pointer is moving, not at steady state, students. If the pointer is moving, how many torques are acting on the pointer? Come on, students. How many torques are acting on the pointer? If the pointer is moving or if the pointer is oscillating, how many torques are acting on the pointer? 3 torques are acting on the pointer. If it is at steady state, only 2 torques are acting. Only 2 torques are acting on the pointer. Point to remember, students. If the pointer is moving, how many torques are acting on the pointer? 3 torques. Deflecting torque, controlling torque and damping torque. 3 torques are acting on the pointer. One more question I am asking, students. If the pointer is at steady state condition, what is the resultant torque? Can anybody answer, students? If the pointer is at steady state condition, what is the resultant torque? Yes, very good. If the pointer is at steady state condition, what is the resultant torque, students? Come on. If the pointer is at steady state condition, what is the resultant torque, students? Can anybody answer this one? If the pointer is at steady state condition, what the resultant torque? Yes, sir. These two torques are acting. These two torques are equal and opposite. Equal and opposite. For example, this is 5 Newton meter. This is also 5 Newton meter. Equal and opposite means 5 minus 5 is 0. That's why there is no any resultant torque. The resultant torque is equal to 0. Very important, students. Deflecting torque is present. Controlling torque is also present. But these two torques are equal and opposite. That's the reason why the resultant torque equal to 0, damping torque equal to 0. But which torques are present? Deflecting torque and controlling torques are present. Deflecting torque and controlling torques are present at steady state. The torques are there, but resultant torque equal to 0. If the resultant torque equal to 0, the pointer is not moving. Yes, friends, please concentrate. Yeah, one more question. Come on, friends. In moving iron instrument, eddy current damping cannot be used. Eddy current damping cannot be used. Why, students? Why eddy current damping is used? Why eddy current damping is not used? We know that in moving iron instrument, which damping is preferable? Which damping is preferable? Air friction damping is used. In moving iron instrument, air friction damping is used. Air friction damping is used, students. In moving iron instrument, which damping is preferable? Air friction damping. Even in electrodynamometer type instrument also, we can use the air friction damping. What about in PMMC instruments, friends? In PMMC instrument, what type of damping you can use? In PMMC, eddy current damping. Wherever the permanent magnet is there, we can use the eddy current damping. In electrostatic voltmeter, friends, we can use air friction or fluid friction. This is a special application. We can use air friction or fluid friction, students. It is a special application. In electrostatic, voltmeter only we can use the fluid friction. But simply remember, students, like this. If any instrument is consist of permanent magnet, your answer is eddy current damping. But in electrostatic voltmeter, fluid friction damping is also used. What is the application of fluid friction damping? Students, the instruments which having the less sensitivity, In that instruments, we can use the fluid friction damping. One more question here. Among all the instruments, which is the less sensitivity? Among all the instruments, which instrument is the very less sensitivity? Electrostatic voltmeter is the less sensitivity. Very important. That's why we are using the fluid friction damping. Students, if there is a permanent magnet, it is current damping. Electrostatic voltmeter, we can use either air friction or fluid friction. But remaining most of the all the instrument, if there is no permanent magnet, in most of the remaining all the instrument, which damping you can use? Air friction damping is used. Air friction damping is used. Yes, friends, come on. What is the answer for this question, friends? Why eddy current damping is not used with the MI type instruments? Can anybody answer this question, friends? Why eddy current damping is not used in the MI instruments? Why eddy current damping is not used in the MI type instruments? Can anybody answer this one, friends? Come on, friends. Yes. Yes, friends. Yes. Which is more sensitivity? Students, among all the instruments, highest sensitivity is electronic DC voltmeter. If it is not there, electronic DC voltmeter means amplifier type voltmeters are highest sensitivity. If it is not there, your answer is PMMC. PMMC is the highest sensitivity. If electronic DC voltmeter or amplifier type voltmeter is not there. If amplifier type or electronic DC voltmeter is there, then that is your answer. Students. Yes, friends. Yes. Is it okay? Now tell us, friends. In moving iron instrument, eddy current damping cannot be used. Yes. The introduction of permanent magnet required for eddy current damping. For eddy current damping, compulsory it requires the permanent magnet. Will disturb the existing weak operating magnetic field. That's the reason why we are not using the eddy current damping. If you introduce the permanent magnet, permanent magnet is a very strong magnet. If you introduce that one, the weak magnetic field will be distorted. Because of that reason, we are not using the eddy current damping. Students, see, in MI type instrument, what the range of flux density? Can anybody answer? The range of flux density is 0.0062 Weber per meter square to, students, 0.0075 Weber per meter square. Okay, this point you remember? This is in MI type instrument. What about in EDM instruments? In EDM instrument, 0.005 Weber per meter square to 0.006 Weber per meter square. This is the range of flux density in EDM instrument. What about in PMMC instrument? In PMMC instrument, the range of flux density is 0.1 Weber per meter square to 1 Weber per meter square. That's why, which instrument is the very weak magnetic field? EDM. Next, MI. Next, highest flux density is PMMC. If you compare the flux density instruments, friends, the flux density of PMMC is greater than flux density of MI is greater than the flux density of EDM instrument, which is the weak magnetic field. EDM instrument is the weak magnetic field. Come on, friends. Come on. Okay. In PMMC instrument, which damping we can use? Eddy current damping. But in ESV, air friction or fluid friction also we can use. What is the application of fluid friction? The instrument which having the less sensitivity, in that instrument we can use the fluid friction. Yes. A wattmeter reads 25.34 watts. The absolute error in the measurement is -0.11 watt. Determine the true value of the power. Yes, friends, can anybody answer? It's a very simple question. We know that absolute error equal to what the formula? It's a very simple question. absolute error equal to measured power minus true power. Yes friends, measured power minus true power. What is the absolute error given? Minus 0.11 is equal to, you want to find the true power. What is the measured power? 25.34 minus true power. Then what the true power equal to students? 25.34 plus 0.11. How much you can get? 25.45 x. Which option is correct? Option A is correct. Very good students. Very good. All are given correct answer. 25.45 x. One more question students. The meter X and Y requires 40 milliampere and 50 milliampere respectively for full scale deflection. Then which is the more sensitive? Yes friends. We know that what is IFSDX? IFSDX. The full scale deflection of meter X is 40 milliampere. The full scale deflection of meter Y is 50 milliampere. We know that friends, the sensitivity equal to 1 by full scale deflection current. The sensitivity equal to 1 by full scale. If full scale deflection current is high, the sensitivity is less. Then which is the less sensitivity students? X is more sensitivity, Y is more sensitive, both are equal sensitive, not possible to determine from the given data. Then which is more sensitive? X is the more sensitive. X is the more sensitive. Very good friends. Next. Come on. An unshielded moving iron voltmeter is used to measure the voltage in AC circuit. If a straight DC magnetic field having a component along the axis of the meter coil appears, the meter reading would be. Yes friends, this is the error due to stray magnetic fields. Error due to stray magnetic field. Due to stray magnetic field, the meter may show the either higher values or lower values based on the direction of the stray magnetic field students. This meter shows either higher value or lower values based on the direction of the magnetic field, stray magnetic field. Stray magnetic field means this is the error due to external magnetic field. Error due to external magnetic field. Let us assume that this is the main field. This is the main field. And this is the stray magnetic field. If the stray field, both are in the same direction, then flux is increases, theta is also increases. For example, this is the main field students. This is the main field. This is the main field. And this is the stray magnetic field. Stray magnetic field. Then flux is reducing, theta also reducing. Why? If the flux is reducing, what about the torque students? If the flux is increasing, what about the torque? Torque is increases. That's why theta is increases. If the flux is reducing, why theta is reducing? If the flux is reducing, deflecting torque is reducing, students. Yeah, if it is not visible here, I'm writing here. Please concentrate. If the main magnetic field and stray magnetic field, this is the main field and this is the stray magnetic field, is in opposite direction, then what the flux reduces? What the deflecting torque reduces? What the theta? That's why the meter shows either higher values or lower values. Very good, friends. The meter shows either higher values or lower values. Come on, friends. One more question. The sawtooth voltage waveform shown in the figure is fed to a moving iron voltmeter. Its reading would be close to. Yes. Given that moving iron voltmeter, what the moving iron meter measures, friends? What the moving iron meter measures? MI measures. MI measures RMS value. RMS value. MI measures. Find the RMS value of this waveform. It is a triangular waveform. What the RMS value? For a triangular waveform, what the RMS value? That is Vm by root 3. Vm by root 3. Then what is VRMS, friends? That is 100 by root 3. How much we can get? 57.7 volts we can get. 57.7 volts. Very good. A very important model. These models we can expect. By giving the waveform also we can expect the questions, friends. By giving the waveform also we can expect the questions. But here note I am giving. You please concentrate to answer any questions. Note I am giving. Yes, friends. PMMC is average value. Rectifier type meter is. Rectifier instrument is average value. Yes friends, MI, ESV, hot wire, thermocouple, EDM, most of the, all these instruments is which one? RMS. Point to remember. This measures the RMS value. MI, ESV. MI, ESV. Yes, friends. Hot wire meter, thermocouple, EDM meter measures the RMS value. What about the electronic AC voltmeter? I think already given this one, this series. You please go through that one. What the electronic AC voltmeter measures? Electronic AC voltmeter, friends. Electronic AC voltmeter is, yeah, this point you remember? Yes, friends. Electronic AC voltmeter measures average measuring and RMS indicating. Then it measures what is its indicated value is 1.11 VDC. What is its indicated value, friends? 1.11 VDC. It indicates the 1.11 VDC. That point to remember. Electronic AC voltmeter is average measuring and RMS indicating type instrument. Average measuring and RMS. Next, come on, friends. One more question. An ideal voltage source and an ideal voltmeter have internal impedances respectively. Yes, friends. Voltage source and voltmeter. Voltage source is different. Voltmeter is different. Yes, friends. Current source is different. Ammeter is different. Yes, voltage source is ideally. Here I am comparing ideal and practical. Yes, friends. If you take voltage source, voltmeter. Yes, friends. Current source, ammeter. To answer any question, this remember. Yes, friends. Here I am giving ideally, practically. Practically, I am talking about input resistance. Which resistance, friends? Input resistance. Voltage source input resistance ideally zero, practically low. Voltmeter input resistance ideally infinity, practically high. The statements is important, friends. Current source ideally input resistance is infinity, practically high. Yes, friends. Ammeter, ideally input resistance is zero, practically low. Then what it is asked? An ideal voltage source and ideal voltmeter having internal impedances respectively. Voltage source is zero, then voltmeter is infinite. Option B is correct. Very good, friends. Option B is correct. But to answer any questions, you please remember this one. Ideally practical. Sometimes it is asking practically also. Voltage source zero, low. Voltmeter infinity high. Current source ideally infinite resistance, practically high. But ammeter is zero resistance, practically low resistance. This is the for input resistance, students. You please concentrate these points to answer any question. Next, an advantage of PMMC instrument is that, come on, students, what is the advantage of PMMC instrument, friends? Come on, friends. Can anybody answer this question? What is the advantage of PMMC instrument? Come on, friends. Can anybody answer this one? Yes. What are the advantage of PMMC instruments, friends? Scale is linear. Yes. High torque to weight ratio. Yes. High accuracy. Yes. All the above. Option C is, yeah, option D, students. This is option D. All are correct. That's why option D is correct. All the above is the correct. Scale. In PMMC instrument, scale is linear. High torque to weight ratio. Very important, students. High torque by weight ratio indicates. High sensitivity. Friends, high sensitivity. This torque to weight ratio is also indicates figure of merit. Torque to weight ratio is also indicate figure of merit is nothing but a sensitivity. One more point, friends. If the torque by weight ratio is increases, what are the frictional errors, students? Friction errors are reduces. Yes, what is the sensitivity? Sensitivity is increases. High torque to weight ratio indicate the high sensitivity. That's why among all the instruments, which instrument is the high torque to weight ratio? PMM's instrument is the high torque to weight ratio. If the torque to weight ratio is more, the frictional errors are less. High torque to weight ratio indicate the high sensitivity. Yes, students, in PMM's instrument, what are the scale? Scale is linear. Students, in MI instrument, what the scale? Scale is non-uniform or non-linear. Non-uniform or non-linear. Yes, friends. In EDM instrument also, scale is non-linear. In hot wire meter also, scale is non-linear, students. Yes. What about in rectifier type voltmeter? In rectifier type instrument, can anybody answer? In rectifier type instrument, what are the scale? Scale is linear. Scale is linear, students. In rectifier type instrument, scale is linear. In ESV, what are the scale? Non-linear. In ESV, scale is non-linear scale, students. Rectifier type instrument, scale is linear. In watt meter, can anybody answer? In watt meter, scale is which one? In watt meter, scale is which one, students? Come on. In watt meter, what about the scale? Is a linear scale or non-linear scale? In watt meter, scale is linear or non-linear? Come on, students. Can anybody answer this one? Yeah, scale is linear. Very important. Scale is linear. In watt meter, scale is linear. In watt meter, scale is linear. ESV, non-linear. But rectifier type instrument, scale is linear. Rectifier type instrument, is the scale is linear. In electronic AC voltmeter, students. That is in electronic AC voltmeter. In electronic AC voltmeter, this is one of the advantages of electronic AC voltmeter, scale is linear. Yes, but in wattmeter scale is linear. In wattmeter scale is linear, not non-linear. Please concentrate. It's very important. Power measuring, sir. Power measuring. Yes. One more important question, friends. In the context of PMM's instrument, identify the correct matches. In the context of PMM's instrument, identify the correct matches. Yes, friends. A pair of springs are used. A pair of springs are used to provide controlling torque, to provide current in and out of the moving coil. Yes, sir. The springs is also carries the current. Aluminium former is used to produce damping torque, and it also base for the coil. That is, A is matching with P and S. A is matching with P and S. B is matching with Q and R. Which option is correct, friends? Option C is correct. Yeah, watt meter is scale is linear. Theta is proportional to P. Theta directly indicates the power. That's why theta is proportional to P. No. It's not Benally. That is not I square R here. The deflection of a pointer, this is the concept here. The deflection of a pointer directly proportional to the power. Here don't take the I square. We are not measuring the current. We are measuring the power. According to you, what you are telling, theta is proportional to I square R, sir. But it is a power. Finally, I don't want current, sir. I want to calibrate the scale in terms of power. Not in terms of current. That's the reason why. In wattmeter, in electrodynamometer wattmeter, that is important. In electrodynamometer wattmeter, scale is linear. Yes, friends. We are calibrating the scale in terms of the power, not in terms of the current. Yes, friends. Which option is correct? Option C is correct. Very important. Yes. Come on, friends. During the measurement of voltage and current in load, ammeter and voltmeters are connected in series and across the load respectively. If the ammeter and voltmeter positions are interchanged by mistake, Students, here the what is the type of circuit is not given. Ammeter and voltmeters are connected in series and across the load respectively. That means generally ammeters are connected series. Voltmeters are connected across the load. Okay, that is correct. Shunt connected. Now, if voltmeter and ammeter positions are interchanged, here, very important statement here, friends. If the question is asked like this, always which meter will be damaged? Ammeter only damaged. The voltmeter never damaged. Ammeter only damaged, sir. The voltmeter never damaged. The voltmeter never damaged. That point you remember. Without giving the circuit, if the question is asked like this, your answer is ammeter will be damaged. But if the circuit is given, if the circuit is given, according to circuit you answer. For example, students, for example, ammeter is connected like this. Voltmeter is connected like this. Now tell me, in this circuit, ammeter and voltmeter positions are interchanged. Then which meter is damaged? Can anybody answer this one? Which meter is damaged? Interchanged. Then which meter is damaged? In this circuit, if the ammeter and voltmeter positions are interchanged. See, this question circuit is not given. That's why your answer is ammeter is damaged. But here I am giving the circuit. Now tell me, in this circuit, if the ammeter and voltmeter positions are damaged, then which meter is damaged? Yeah, none of the meter will damage. Very good, very good. Why? Because when I connect voltmeter here, when I connect ammeter here, voltmeter offers high input resistance. It cannot allow the current. Once it cannot allow the current, there is no damage of the meter. That is very important. Please concentrate. If circuit is not given, your answer is ammeter is damaged. If the circuit is given, according to circuit you can answer. But in this circuit, no meter, none of the meter will damage. Very important. None of the meter will damage. Yes, students, please concentrate. This type of model also we can expect. Yes, friends. None of the meter will damage. Yeah. Voltmeter will not damage, sir. Voltmeter never damage because it offers high input resistance. The damage is in the circuit is only ammeter. But here, ammeter also not damaged because at input side there is a voltmeter. Yes, friends. One more question. Come on, friends. Very good. Very good. Yeah, I equal to 0. That's why no damage of the ammeter. No damage of the ammeter. Hari, across the load there will be low current, no? So then why ammeter is damaged? Yeah, this case I am telling that. Yeah, here ammeter is not damaged. But if you change the circuit condition, that will damage, Hari. Okay. This is the reason. What you are asking, Hari? For example, I am changing the circuit like this. For example, voltmeter is here. Ammeter is here. This is the load. Okay, this is the circuit condition. Now we can change the ammeter. Here I connected ammeter, I connected voltmeter. Then ammeter offers very low resistance. Ammeter offers very low resistance. The total current is bypassed through ammeter. Then ammeter is short circuited. Ammeter will be damaged. That is the reason. In this circuit only ammeter is damaged. But here ammeter will not damage. Here if you interchange the positions, in this circuit ammeter will be damaged. Understand, Hari? Is it okay? Yes, friends. Next, to increase the range of voltmeter, it's a very simple question. A high resistance in series is connected with the voltmeter. Very good. One more question. A DC voltage of magnitude 11 kV is to be measured without loading the source under steady state condition. The best suited instrument is which one, friends? Which is the best suited instrument? Yes, friends. Which is the best suitable instrument? Very important. Very important question, friends. I am giving the statement. Please remember. For any type of waveform, it may be DC or AC or sinusoidal or non-sinusoidal. For any type of waveform, to measure the very high voltages, electrostatic voltmeters are used. Very important, sir. Electrostatic voltmeters are used for measurement of high voltages. Sir, question is voltage measurement, not the resistance measurement. High resistance measurement measure is correct. Here I am asked voltage measurement. For any type of waveform, it may be sinusoidal, non-sinusoidal, AC or DC. To measure the very high voltages, which voltmeter is used? Electrostatic voltmeter is used. Some points I am giving with respect to electrostatic voltmeter. Students, one point to remember, electrostatic instruments used as only voltmeters. Are you seeing any electrostatic ammeters? We don't have any electrostatic ammeter. The name itself, it indicates that electrostatic effect. Static effect means there is no moment of charge. That's why these are used only voltmeters. Very important, students. Yes. Used for high voltage measurement. Yes. Lowest sensitivity, students. These are the lowest sensitivity. Highest cost. Among all the voltmeters, which voltmeter is the high cost? Electrostatic voltmeters are high cost. Yes, friends. No stray magnetic field errors. There is no stray magnetic field errors. Because there is no magnetic field. Here we are using electrostatic field. There is no stray magnetic field errors. Yes, friends. What the deflecting torque of electrostatic voltmeter? TD equal to half V square into DC by D theta. Very important. TD equal to half V square into DC by D theta. This is the deflecting torque. What the deflecting torque equation, students? What the theta? 1 by 2K, students. Yes. 1 by 2K. This is V square into DC by D theta. V square into DC by D theta. This is the deflection of the pointer. How to extend the range of electrostatic voltmeters? Range is extended by. Which one, friends? How to extend the range? Range is extended by series capacitors. And one more is potential divider arrangement. Yes, friends. We can use the series capacitors. Yes, friends. We can use the series capacitors and also use the potential divider arrangement. The range is extended by series capacitors. Then we can also use the potential divider arrangement. Yes, friends. To extend the range of electrostatic voltmeter, what the value of CS? CS equal to CM by M minus 1. What is the value of series capacitance? The value of series capacitance is equal to CM by M minus 1. How to extend the range of electrostatic voltmeter? Based on this, I am not framing the questions. That's why this also we can expect. That's why not asked, but we can expect. CM by M minus 1. What is M here, friends? M equal to V by Vm. CM is meter capacitance. That you write. What is the deflecting torque equation? Yes, friends. How to extend the range? By using series capacitor, by using potential divider arrangement. That points also you remember. Yes, friends. Next, one more question. A moving coil ammeter has fixed strength of 0.02 ohm resistance. If the coil resistance of the meter is 1000 ohms, a potential difference of 500 millivolts is required across it for full scale deflection. Under this condition, the current in the shunt is would be dash. Yes, students. Come on. What is the answer for this question, students? Yes, given that PMMC instrument, it's a very simple question. How to convert PMMC as a ammeter that you know? This is the meter resistance. Yes, friends. And this is the meter current. And we are connecting shunt like this. Here, this is the RSH. And this is the ISH. Then you find the what is the shunt current. You want to find the what the shunt current means. How to find the shunt current means? Then IM into RM equal to ISH into RSH. Voltage across the two parallel branches is equal. What is ISH, students? What the meter current is given? How much meter current is given? But IM into RM is given, 500 millivolts. What is RSH students? The shunt resistance is how much? 0.02. 0.02. This is how much you can get. Can anybody answer, students? There is a 2 into 10 power minus 2. That you can get 10 power minus 1. That is 250. That is how much you can get, students? How much you can get? 500 into 10 power minus 3 by 0.02. What is the value of shunt current we can get? Can anybody answer this one? What is the value of shunt current we can get? Is it B? Yes, students. 0.5 by 0.02. That is 50 by 2. 50 by 2 means 25 amperes. Is it correct? Very good. Very good. Very good. Yeah, 25. Don't. See, please concentrate on the calculations. Please concentrate. You know the formula, but don't do the silly mistakes like calculations. Yes, one more question, friends. The inductance of a certain moving iron ammeter is expressed as L equal 10 plus 3 theta minus theta square by 4 micro Henry, where theta is the, this is very simple. You want to find the deflection of the pointer. In moving iron instrument, what is theta? 1 by 2k I square into dl by d theta. 1 by 2k I square into dl by d theta, friends. Now, you want to find the theta. Theta equal to 1 by 2 into, what is k given? 25 into 10 to the power of minus 6. I square is 5 square. D by d theta, L equal to 10 plus 3 theta minus theta square by 4 micro Henry. Micro Henry means 10 power minus 6. 10 power minus 6 cancel. 25, 25 cancel. What is theta equal to, students? 1 by 2 into, you differentiate this one, what you can get? 3 minus 2 theta by 4. Yes. 2 theta equal to how much you can get, students? 2 theta equal to how much? 3 minus theta by 2. Then 5 theta by 2 equal to 3. Then what is theta equal to? 6 by 5. The 6 by 5 is 1.2. Is it radian or degree? Is it radian or degree? Is decided based on the K units. Is decided based on the K units, friends. What are the K units? Newton meter per radian. That's why the theta units also in radians. The theta units also in radians. Please concentrate. The theta units is also in radians. Then which option is correct, friends? 1.2 radians. Which option is correct? 1.2 radians. Very good, sir. Very good. It's a 1.2 radians. Come on, friends. Yeah, this is the formula you can use to solve this problem. Just I differentiated, then I find the value of theta. Then I find the value of theta. Use this formula. I told already this formula, students. Next, come on, friends. One more question. Consider the following statements associated with moving iron instruments. Consider the following statements associated with moving iron instruments. Very good. Come on. Consider the following statements associated with moving iron instruments, friends. Moving iron instruments. Come on. Yeah, this can be used in DC as well as AC circuits. Which of these statements are correct? This can be used as DC as well as AC circuits. The scale is non-uniform. The moving iron is placed in the field of permanent magnet. Which option is correct? 1 and 2. Option B is correct. Very good, Amit. Very good, Amit. Devi Prasanna. Happy. All of you, very good. Yes, friends. All are given correct answer. Abhishek. Yes, sir. Pramod. All are giving correct answer, sir. Yes, friends. One more question. A voltage of 200 volts at 5 hertz is applied to an electrodynamometer type of instrument. Which is spring control? The indication of the instrument is, students, I told already, these are used for 40 hertz to 500 hertz, or you can also use for 50 hertz to 1000 hertz. But below 15 hertz, these are not preferable. These instruments follows the variations in the voltage and does not give the steady state value. That means the pointer is always oscillating. The pointer is always oscillating for low frequencies. That's which option is correct, friends? Option C is correct. Option C is correct. A voltage of 200 volts at 5 hertz, is applied to electrodynamometer. Very important. Electrodynamometer, sir. It's an AC instrument. It can measure AC. But for very low frequencies, the pointer is oscillates. The pointer is oscillates. It is having very weak magnetic field. Very weak magnetic field, friends. That's why which option is correct, friends? Which option is correct? Yes, 26 is not B, sir. 26 is the C is the correct. Given is electrodynamometer. It is not PMMC. It is not PMMC. Students, please don't confuse. Given is electrodynamometer. It is not PMMC. Very important here. That's why the pointer is oscillate for low frequency. I given this statement already. Next, moving iron instrument when measuring voltage or currents. Yes, friends. When measuring voltage or currents, then what is the correct answer, friends? Indicate the higher value for measured for ascending values. Indicates higher value for measured for descending order. Yeah, this you know this concept. For ascending order, this is the output. For descending order, this is the output. This is for ascending order. This is for, this is the output value, sir. This is the output values. For descending order input. That's why, for which case it gives the more output. Indicate the higher values for measurand for descending values. Indicate the higher values for measurand for descending values. Yes, friends. It indicates the higher values of measurand for descending order. Friends, please concentrate, sir. If input is increasing, if input is ascending order, you have any doubt here? Please, I am drawing once again. If input is ascending order, measurand means input. Yes, friends. If input is ascending order, we can get these readings. If input is descending order, this is the output value, sir. Descending order, we can get these values. Due to which effect? Due to hysteresis. This is due to hysteresis, sir. Why this is happening like this? Due to which effect? Due to hysteresis errors. Among all the instruments, which instruments offer the more hysteresis errors? Due to hysteresis errors. That's why for descending order of input values, measurand means input values, it shows the higher values. Among all the instruments. Yes, Ashok, welcome to the session. Yes, friends, among all the instruments, which instrument offers the more hysteresis errors, sir? Come on, friends. MI instrument offers the more hysteresis errors. Next. A 200 volts full scale deflection PMMC type DC voltmeters having figure of merit of 10 kilo ohms per volt, 20 kilo ohms per volt are connected in series. That series combination used to measure maximum DC voltage of. Yes, friends, it is given that two voltmeters are connected in series. What is the maximum voltage measured by using this series combination? Direct formula I am giving. The maximum voltage measured by using this series combination equal to IFSD minimum. Minimum deflection current into S1 into V1 plus S2 into V2. Plus and so on. Any number of voltmeters are connected like this. What is IFSD minima, students? In this, which gives the minimum deflection current? Yes, friends. IFSD minima equal to high sensitivity is the minimum deflection current. 1 by 20 kilo ohm per volt. How much we can get, students? 0.05 milliamperes. 0.05 milliamperes. Now you substitute here, students. You substitute here. Minimum deflection current is 0.05 milliamperes. S1 is 20 kilo ohm per volt. V1 is 100 volts. S2 is 10 kilo ohm per volt. 10 kilo ohm per volt. Yes, friends, 10 kilo ohm per volt into 100 volts. How much we can get, friends? This is 0.05 into 20 plus 0.05. This you multiply this one, how much you can get, friends? 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 3 is cancelled. This is how much you can get, 100. This how much we can get, friends? 50. 100 plus 50, how much we can get? 150 volts. Then which option is correct, friends? Which option is correct? 2080C. Very good. 2080C. You find the minimum deflection current. How to get the minimum deflection current? You take the maximum sensitivity. To get the minimum deflection current, take the maximum sensitivity, students. Maximum sensitivity, sir, students. Then you substitute here. IFSD minima into S. Any number of voltmeters are connected. Use this formula. IFSD minima into S1 into V1 plus S2 into V2 plus S3 into V3 and so on. Then how much we can get? 150 volts. Next. Yes, friends. A moving iron type instrument can be used as. Come on, students. A moving iron instrument can be used as. Come on. Standard instrument for calibration of other instruments, transfer type instruments, indicator type instrument as on panels. I told already. Yes, sir. These are instruments are used as a panel instruments only. These instruments are used as a panel type instruments only. Panel mounted instruments. More preferable for power frequency. Moving iron instruments are more preferable for power frequency. Used as a panel mounted instruments. Used as a panel mounted instruments. Come on, students. Which is the transfer instruments? What are the examples of transfer instruments, students? EDM is the example of transfer instrument. Hot wire meter is also example of transfer instrument. Hot wire meter is also example of transfer instrument. What do you mean by transfer instrument, students? Whose calibration is same for both AC and DC? Whose calibration is? What is the example of transfer instrument? Electrodynamometer and hot wire meter. Whose calibration is same for both AC and DC? Same for both AC and DC. Both AC and DC. That's why these are instruments are used as a transfer instrument, students. Next, one more question. An electrodynamometer type instrument find the major use as. An electrodynamometer type instrument find the major use as. Yes, students, please concentrate. Both as standard and transfer instrument. Yes, this is correct. You can use as a standard instrument and also use as a transfer instrument. And also use it as a transfer instrument. Come on, students. Next. A DC voltmeter has a sensitivity of 1000 ohm per volt. What is its half full scale deflection current? Very simple. What is the full scale deflection current? Full scale deflection current equal to 1 by sensitivity. 1 by 1000 ohm per volt, students. How much we can get? 1 milliampere. But you want half full scale deflection current. What the half full scale deflection current, students? Yeah, 1 by 2. That is half full scale deflection current equal to IFSD by 2. IFSD by 2. IFSD by 2. How much we can get, students? 0.5 milliamperes. Next question. Yes, friends. Very good. Very good. Come on. Which one of the following multi-range voltmeter has highest input impedance and less loading effect? Which instrument is the highest input impedance and less loading effect, friends? Very, very important. Point to remember. If the sensitivity is high, input resistance is high, loading effect is less. Very important. Loading effect is less. Yes, friends. If the sensitivity is high, input resistance is high, loading effect is less. Which voltmeter is having highest input resistance? I told already, amplifier type voltmeters are having highest input resistance. Amplifiers are very important. Amplifiers will offer the high input resistance. Amplifiers will offer the high input resistance. Very important. That's why amplifier type voltmeters are having the highest input resistance, high sensitivity. Yes, high sensitivity also. High sensitivity also. High sensitivity also, friends. You please concentrate. You please concentrate. Next. A 0 to 10 milliampere 100 ohms PMMC instrument converted as 100 volts full wave rectified type voltmeter. The sensitivity of this voltmeter is, it's very simple, I already given the formula. What is the SAC of full wave rectifier? 0.9 times of SDC. 0.9 times of SDC. That is 0.9 into 1 by full scale deflection current. Yes, friends. 0.9 into full scale deflection current is how much, friends? This is 10 milliampere. 10 milliampere. That is how much? 90 ohm per volt. 90 ohm per volt. Option A is correct. Mukesh Kumar, previous question. You are asking for previous. Yeah. Which of the following multi-range? Yeah. Permanent magnet moving coil, amplifier type, electronic. Yes, correct. Yes, Mukesh. If B is not given, your answer is A. If B is not given, your answer is A. Yeah, that is correct. Very good. Yeah, this is 90 ohm per volt. Yes, very good. Next question, students. What are the causes of gross errors in the instruments? Come on, friends. What are the causes of gross errors in the instruments? Come on, come on. Which are the causes of gross errors, students? These gross errors are due to human mistakes. Gross errors are due to human mistakes. Misreading of the instrument. Incorrect adjustments of the instrument. Error due to defective instrument. This is a systematic error. This is a systematic error. That is instrumental errors. Instrumental errors. This is instrumental error. Error due to effect of environment. It is also systematic error. It is also systematic error. What is systematic error? This is the environmental error. Environmental errors also systematic errors. Environmental errors also systematic errors. Environmental errors also systematic errors. Environmental errors also systematic error. Which option is correct? 1 and 2. 1 and 2. A. Very good. 34th is A question. Very good. 35. The errors introduced by instrument fall in which category? The errors introduced by instrument fall in which category? Systematic, random, gross, environmental errors. Systematic errors. Yes, sir. Yes, friends. What are the systematic errors? The systematic errors are instrumental errors. Instrumental errors. Instrumental errors. Yes, friends. Next, environmental errors. Environmental errors. Environmental errors. Another one is observational errors. Observational errors. Observational errors. All these are the systematic errors. Instrumental errors, environmental errors, and observational errors. What are the examples of instrumental errors? Yes, friends. One is loading error. Loading error. Error due to aging effect. Error due to aging effect. Error due to aging effect. Error due to irregular spring tension. Error due to irregular spring tension. Error due to irregular spring tension. Irregular spring tension. Irregular springs. Springs tension. Yes, friends. And gross guarantee accuracy error. And limiting error. Limiting error. All these are the which errors, friends? All these are the which errors? Yes, friends. These are the instrumental errors. Loading error, error due to aging effect, error due to irregular spring tension, guarantee accuracy error, limiting error. All these are the instrumental errors. What are the environmental errors? Temperature errors and stray magnetic field errors. Temperatures and stray magnetic field errors. Stray magnetic field error. What are the observational errors? Parallax error. Parallax error is the observational error. That point to remember. Parallax error is the observational error. Next. Match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answers using the course given below. But here I am not given. Directly you can match, friends. Sensitivity. Sensitivity is which one, friends? Ratio of response to change in input. That is A is 3. Resolution. Resolution, smallest change in input which can be detected by an instrument. B is 4. B is 4. Accuracy. Closeness to the true value. C is 1. C is 1. Precision. A measure of reproducibility of the instrument. A measure of reproducibility of the instrument. D is 2. D is too small. A3B4C1D2. 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 Is okay, students? Please concentrate. Yes, sir. In measurement system, which of the following are undesirable static characteristics? Which of the following is undesirable static characteristics? Undesirable static characteristics. But it is asked undesirable static. Yes, sir. Drift, static error, dead zone, and non-linearity. All these are the undesirable static characteristics. In measurement system, which of the following are undesirable static characteristics? Drift, static error, dead zone, and non-linearity. All these are the undesirable static errors, friends. All these are the undesirable static errors. Is it okay, friends? Come on. Clear? Yes. Come on, friends. In measurement system, which of the following are desirable dynamic characteristics? Very important. Desirable dynamic characteristics. Which of the following is the desirable dynamic characteristics, friends? Can anybody answer? Come on. Can anybody answer, friends? Come on. Which of the desirables are not undesirable, desirable dynamic characteristics? In this question, for 38th question, I'm asking. For 38. Yes, previous question, Mukesh, you given option D. Very good. 37 is D. Very good. I'm asking 38. In measurement system, which of the following is the desirable dynamic characteristics? Desirable dynamic characteristics. Very good. Speed of response and fidelity. These undesirable dynamic characteristics are Yes, friend. These are the undesirable dynamic characteristics. Come on, friends. These are the undesirable dynamic characteristics. Next. A 300 volts full scale deflection voltmeter has an accuracy of less or minus 2%. When it reads 222 volts, the actual voltage is, come on, friends, what is the actual voltage? It's very simple. Just you find the absolute error. You want the actual voltage, friends. What the measured value is given 322 volts? You find the absolute error. You find the absolute error, friends. It's very simple. You calculate plus or minus 2% of 300. Plus or minus 200, 2 by 100 into 300, plus or minus 6 volts. Then what the actual voltage? Just add this absolute error to whatever the value we are measuring. The actual voltage. Calculate the absolute error, add to this one. 322 plus or minus 6. How much, friends? This we can get 216 volts and 228 volts. 216 volts and 228 volts. Very good. Option C is correct. Very good, friends. Very good. Next. This is 5-star model. Compulsory question. Even though it is a repeated, sir, compulsory question. Okay, that is very important. Gunshot is a 5-star model. The voltage measured by this instrument is 75 volts. What the percentage limiting error? Very important. The percentage limiting error equal to full scale reading by, yes, friends, true value into plus or minus percentage accuracy at full scale. What the full scale reading? 150. What the true value? 75. Yeah, what voltage to be measured is true value. The voltage to be measured is a true value. What the accuracy at full scale? Plus or minus 1%. How much you can get, friends? Plus or minus 2%. Yes, option B is correct. Very good, very good. It's a gunshot question. Very important. Yes, friends. The total current I equal to I1 plus I2. In a circuit measured, I1 equal to 150 plus or minus 1 ampere, 250 plus or minus 2 amperes I2. Where the limits are given in standard deviation, sir. Given errors is standard deviation. If the statement is not there, your answer is 400 plus or minus 3. But given errors is standard deviation. Given is I equal to I1 plus I2. What is sigma I1, students? Sigma I1 equal to plus or minus 1 ampere. What is sigma I2? Sigma I2 is plus or minus 2 amperes. In addition and subtraction, student, directly calculate sigma I like this. Sigma I1 square plus sigma I2 square. In addition and subtraction, directly you can do like this. But given errors are Given errors are, students. Yes, given errors are in terms of standard deviation. Square root of, yes friends, 1 square plus 2 square, that is root 5. This root 5 equal 2.24 amperes. Then how much we can get? 400 plus or minus 2.24 amperes. 400 plus or minus 2.24 amperes. Yes friends, next 5 to 5 minutes, my mobile will be switched off. That's why I can't see your whatever comments. That's why, but you can respond every question. I'm not seeing your comments. Next 5 minutes, my mobile will be switched off. That's why I can't see your comments. But continuously, I will explain. Continuously, I will explain up to 1 o'clock or 1:15. Up to 1 o'clock or 1:15, sir. But don't think like this. Sir is not responding for my answer like that. Don't think. But I'm not going to seeing your comments. Okay. Please go through this one. Yes, friends. One more question. A set of independent current measurements taken by 4 observers was recorded as 117.02 milliamperes, 117.11 milliamperes, 117.08 milliamperes. What is the range of error? It's very simple, friends. The range of error equal to, simply you can calculate like this. Range of error equal to, yes, friends, maxima minus plus or minus maxima minus minima by 2. Maximum value minus minimum. Plus or minus maximum minus minima by 2. Yeah, this is the range of error. Plus or minus. What are the maximum values, friends? Maximum error, how much you can take? 0.11. 0.11 minus. Then minimum value is how much, friends? 0.02. Minus 0.02 by 2. That is how much we can get, friends. This is how much we can get. 0.11 minus 0.09. That is 0.09 by 2. 0.09 by 2. It's a 0.09 by 2 means. This is 0.045 milliamperes. Plus or minus. Plus or minus 0.045 milliamperes. Option A is correct, friends. Plus or minus 0.045 milliamps. Next, friends. Two resistances R1 equal to 100 plus or minus 10%, R2 equal to 300 plus or minus 5% are connected in series. The resulting limiting error of the series combination is. Yes, friends. Given that two resistances are connected in series, R equal to R1 plus R2. R equal to R1 plus R2, friends. But if errors are in terms of absolute, then you can add in addition and subtraction, absolute errors are added directly. But given is percentage error, students. Given is percentage. First you convert into absolute. What is the absolute error in R1, students? Come on. What is the absolute error in R1? The absolute error in R1, delta R1 equal to, students. Then what you can get? 100 into plus or minus 10 by 100. This is how much? You plus first to convert into absolute form, plus or minus 10 ohms. What is the absolute error in R2? Delta R2 equal to 300 into plus or minus 5 by 100. How much you can get, friends? Plus or minus 15 ohms. Then what is the resultant resistance? R equal to 100 plus 300 is the 400, plus or minus, this is 10 ohms, this is 15 ohms, 25 ohms. That is plus or minus 25 ohms. Option C is correct, friends. Friends, don't add the percentage errors. Point to remember, in addition and subtraction, absolute errors are added. In multiplication and division, then percentage errors are added. That point to remember. But here, given is percentage, that's why convert into absolute form, then I can add it directly. Then 400 plus or minus 25 ohms. Yes, friends, come on. Next. Yeah, this is repeated. Next. The unknown resistance R4 is measured in Wheatstone bridge by the formula R4 equal to R2 R3 by R1. Yes, friends, you want to find the R4. It's very simple. Yeah, R2 is how much, friends? R2 R3 by R1. R2 R3 by R1. What is R2, friends? 100 plus or minus 0.5%. Yes, come on, friends. What is R3? 842 plus or minus 0.5% by this is how much friends? Yeah, this is how much? R1. R1 is 100 plus or minus 100 plus or minus 0.5%. 100 plus or minus 0.5%. Come on, students. Yeah, this how much you can get? This R4 equal to, yes, friends, 100 842, that is 84200 by 100, that is 8420. This is how much, friends? This is R2 is how much? 1000. R2 is 1000. Please correct this one. Yes, sir. This is 1000. Then what you can get? 8420 plus or minus. In multiplication, percentage errors are added directly. Plus or minus 0.5%, plus or minus 0.5%, 1%. In division also, we can add the percentage error. Plus or minus 1.5%, students. Which option is correct? 8420 plus or minus 1.5%. Yes, friends. Come on. Next. The limiting errors of measurement of power consumed by and the current passing through the resistances are 1.5% and 1% respectively. The limiting error in the measurement of resistance will be, yes friends, P equal to I square R formula. P equal to I square R formula. Then you want to find R equal to P by I square. P by I square, friends. What is the limiting errors in the measurement of power? The limiting error in the measurement of power is plus or minus 1.5%. By what is the limiting error in the measurement of current, students? 1%. Plus or minus 1% square. Then how much you can get? Plus or minus 1.5%. This square directly multiplied to the limiting error. Square means plus or minus 1% into plus or minus 1%. Students, just now I told, in multiplication limiting errors are directly added. Percentage errors. This is 1%, this is 1%, 2%. 2%, 1.5%. Plus or minus 3.5%. This is the error in the measurement of resistance, that is plus or minus 3.5%. Students, sir, you given here square, sir. One square is one, sir, like that, don't think. It is error analysis. It is error analysis, students. One plus or minus 1% means 1%, 1%. We know that in multiplication, limiting errors are, percentage errors are directly added. 1%, 1%, 2%. In division also, it is added, students. It is 1.5%, it is a 2%, 3.5%. Next, come on students. Yes, the resistance of wire is given by the expression 4 rho L by pi d square, where P is the, yes friends, where rho is the resistivity, L is the length, D is the diameter of the wire. The error is measured in each of parameters rho L D is plus or minus 1%. Assuming the errors are independent random variables, yes. This concept is also independent random variables means the errors are in terms of standard deviation, students. Errors are in terms of standard deviation. Yes, very important. Please concentrate. Directly how to answer. Directly how to answer, students. What is P is given? Yes. What is R is given? 4 rho L by phi d square. 4 rho L by phi d square. Then you want resultant standard deviation, percentage sigma r, friends. If the errors are given in terms of percentage, see, in the case of multiplication and division, how to write directly? How to write directly? This is rho power 1, L power 1, D square, friends. Rho power 1 means 1 into percentage sigma rho whole square plus 1 into percentage sigma L whole square plus, yes, friends, this is 2. 2 into percentage sigma d whole square. Like this you can write directly. Then what the percentage standard deviation in the measurement of resistance? All are given 1%. What the percentage sigma p is given? Sigma rho is given. Sigma rho is given 1%, friends. What the percentage sigma l is given? Is also 1%. What the percentage sigma d given, friends? It is a 2% it is given. All these you can substitute. This is 1% square. Plus 1% square plus 2 into 1% square. 2 into 1% square, friends. How to write the formula that you concentrate? This is 2 into 1% square. Then how much you can get? Square root of 1% plus 1% plus 4%. Is okay, friends? 1% plus 1% plus 4% root 6%. Root 6% means how much we can get, friends? Come on. This is root 6%. How much we can get? Which option is correct? Plus or minus? Yes, 2.45%. Yeah, that you can calculate. Plus or minus 2.45%. Yeah, that is the answer. Is it okay, friends? How to answer this? You concentrate. Errors are given in terms of standard deviation. Next. The value of multiply resistance for a DC voltmeter having a 50 volts range with 5 kilo ohm per volt, sensitivity employing is 200 microampere meter movement and having internal resistance of 100 ohms. Yes, friends, it's very simple. Please concentrate. We know that what the total input resistance of voltmeter. The total input resistance of voltmeter RV equal to RM plus RSC. That is the total input resistance of voltmeter. What is RSC equal to? RV minus RM. You know the sensitivity SD equal to RV by V. This is one more formula. What are the units of sensitivity? DC sensitivity, ohm per volt. The units of DC sensitivity is ohm per volt, students. Then you write RSC equal to RV is SDC into V. SDC into V minus RM. Then what are the multiply resistance, students? What are the DC sensitivity? DC sensitivity equal to having 50 volts range with 5 kilo ohm per volt sensitivity. Yes, friends. 5 kilo ohm per volt. 5 kilo ohm per volt into what the voltage it is given. Voltage is 50 volts range. 50 volts range. What the meter resistance? 100 ohms, students. It is 100 ohms. Then you can calculate what is RSC. This RSC is how much, friends? 250 kilo ohms. 250 kilo ohms minus this is how much you can get, friends? 0.1 kilo ohm. 0.1 kilo. 100 ohms I am writing as a 0.1 kilo ohms. Then how much we can get? 249.9 kilo ohms we can get. 249.9 kilo ohms. Yes, option A is correct. Friends, you please write down this formula. This RSC equal, if the sensitivity is given, how to calculate the RSC. Next. This is the question based on the loading effect. This is the question based on the loading effect. Then how to find the voltmeter reading? Here the across this one voltmeter is there. This is the meter. What are the voltmeter reading? Reading of voltmeter. Yeah. V measured equal to Vs into RL effective by Rs plus RL effective. What is RL effective, students? RL effective equal to RV into RL by RL plus RV. Yes. What is RV? RV is the sensitivity is given 20,000 ohm per volt. Yes, friends. This is the sensitivity. 1 volt equal to 20,000 ohms. 20,000 ohms. 20,000 volts means 20,000 ohms. 1 volt equal to 20,000 ohms means 20 kilo ohms. This gives the RV. Because it is 1 volt range voltmeter. It is a 1 volt range voltmeter. It is a 20 kilo ohms. This is 20 kilo ohms into 100 kilo ohms. RL is how much, friends? This RL is how much? 100 kilo ohms. It is RL is 100 kilo ohms by 20 plus 100. 20 plus 100. Okay, this is also in kilo ohms. Okay, this you substitute here. RL effective substitute here. Then we can get V measured equal to 82 millivolts. You simplify that one, friends. We can get 82 millivolts. V measured is how much we can get? 82 millivolts we can get. Is it okay, friends? How much we are getting? 82 millivolts. You substitute RL effective. RS already you know. This is RS. This is RS. You substitute here, then you can get 82 millivolts. Next, friends. In a 2 watt meter method of measuring power in balanced 3 phase circuit, the ratio of the 2 watt meter reading is 1:2. The circuit power factor is dash. It's very simple. To solve the many number of problems in watt meter, use this relation. Tan pi equal to root 3 into, yes, friends, W1 minus W2 by W1 plus W2. Very important formula. To solve the many number of questions based on the 2 watt meter method, use this relation. Yes, friends, 2 watt meter readings, W1 by W2. Is equal to 1 by 2. W1 by W2. Or you take W2 by W1, friends. Ratio of 2 watt meters, you take W2 by W1 or W1 by W2. Okay, whatever you take, that is no problem. I am taking the W2 by W1. The ratio of two wattmeters, friends. W2 by W1 equal to how much? It is 1 by 2. Now we substitute here. What is the tan pi? Tan pi equal to root 3 into 1 minus 1 by 2 by 1 plus 1 by 2. If you want any doubt here, take the W1 is common here. Friends, take the W1 is common. Here I am taking the W1 is common. Just a minute. Yes, friends. Take the W1 is common. What you can get? 1 minus W2 by W1 by 1 plus W2 by W1. This how much you can get, friends? This is root 3. Here also W1 is common. This W1, W1 cancel. Root 3 into 1 minus 1 by 2 by 1 plus 1 by 2. Then what the tan pi you can get, friends? What the tan pi you can get? This is 1 by 2. This 1 by root 3 you can get. Is it correct, friends? Tan pi equal to 1 by root 3 you can get. Then what is the pi? Pi equal to 30 degrees. What is the power factor? Power factor equal to cos pi. That is cos 30. Cos 30 is how much, friends? Root 3 by 2. That is 0.866. 0.866 you can get. The power factor equal to 0.866, friends. Come on. Next, due to the effect of inductance in the pressure coil, a dynamometer type wattmeter is, yes friends, due to the effect of for low power factor and, yes friends, reads high on lagging power factor and low on leading power factor. It is very important. It reads the high value for lagging power factors, friends. It reads the low value for leading power factor, because for lagging power factor, measured power is proportional to cos of pi minus beta. For leading power factor, measured power is proportional to cos of pi plus beta. Actually, instead of measured power, I am taking as a deflecting torque. Deflecting torque. Yes, friends. This is deflecting torque. This also deflecting torque. This is for lagging. For lagging power factor. Yeah, this is for leading power factor. This is for leading power factor, friends. That's why reads high on lagging power factor, low on leading power factor. Get that point to remember. Yes, friends. A wattmeter is as shown in figure. The wattmeter reads. Students, it's a very simple question. Point to remember. Wherever the potential coil is connected, across that only power is measured. Wherever the potential coil is connected, across that only power is measured. Now tell the students, in this case potential coil is connected across Z2. That's why power is consumed by Z2 only. It measures the power in Z2 only. It measures the power in Z2 only. Wherever, for example, this is Z1. This is Z2. This is the Z1, this is the Z2. Now I connected, the pressure coil is like this. Pressure coil is like this. Now the wattmeter measures power in both Z1 and Z2. Wattmeter measures power in both Z1 and Z2. It measures the power in both Z1 and Z2. Yes, friends, get that point to remember. The wattmeter is connected both, it measures the power in both Z1 and Z2. That part. But here, potential coil is connected across Z2 only. That's why it measures only in Z2. Yes, friends. Still, I want to solve the questions based on the energy meters. I want to solve the questions based on, for time being, I am ending this session, today's session. Next, one more session I will take on the measurements. I will complete this one, students. I want to explain the different models of questions on energy meters. I want to explain the different models of questions based on the, yes, friends, bridges. I want to explain the different models of questions based on the bridges and potentiometer, CT and PT. Potentiometer and CT and PT. All these models that I want to cover. For time being, I am ending this session, today's session. Yes, friends, the next coming session, I will take one more session on the measurement to complete remaining topics also. Continuation of power measurement, remaining sessions. In remaining topics is energy meter, CTPT, potentiometer, Q meter. That is electrical measurements. In electronic measurements, I already covered so many problems in one series. You please go through that one. Transducers also I covered. Yes, friends, thank you very much. This is about today's session. This is my Telegram channel. Who are not joined still now, you please join this channel. I will share my whatever the PDF I covered in this today topic, that PDF I will share in this Telegram channel. Students, you please join. This is our GATE 2022 champion study plan. Please go through this one. This is our BAR 2021 boost up course for electrical, EC and mechanical students. For more information, contact this number. This is our Grade Up Super students. Please subscribe for Grade Up Super, who are the aspirants for GATE, ESC and PSU students. Yeah, thank you students. Thank you very much. I will take one more session on the measurements. I will take one more session on the measurements. I will take on the session on the power electronics also for Hall and HPCL. In the next coming session on the measurements, I will cover the power measurement, energy meter, CTPT, yes students, potentiometer, Q meter, and some questions of electronic measurements and transducers also I will cover. Thank you very much, friends. This is about today's session. Thank you, all of you students.